These days, if a television show lasts past the third season, we think it has been a most remarkable achievement. But when you look at some of the comic strips that you have been reading for 10, 20, 30, 40, and sometimes 50 years, then you must admit that this is a most remarkable achievement. For the cartoonist has had to do this literally every day during that long span of time.
You unlock this door with the key of imagination. Beyond it is another dimension. A dimension of sound. A dimension of sight. A dimension of mind. You're moving into a land of both shadow and substance, of things and ideas. You've just crossed over into the Twilight Zone.
Now is the winter of our discontent.
Made glorious summer by this son of York.
This is the Richard III ward.
A hops! A hops! My kingdom for A hops!
Most of these cases are pretty
A hops! A hops! My kingdom!
Treatment does work with some people. This chap came to us straight from the Chichester Festival. We operated just in time, and now he's almost normal.
A horse, my kingdom for a horse.
You didn't have to kill me. She ain't do no harm to us, to any of us.
No harm.
They owned you, okay? He owned you, and when he died, she owned you. You were their possession.
Some men change their times. One man changed the world for all time.
My name is Gandhi, Mohandas K. Gandhi.
Well, whoever you are, we don't want you here. I suggest you get back on that train before it leaves.
They seem to want me.
Columbia Pictures presents a Richard Attenborough film, Gandhi.
100,000 Englishmen simply cannot control 350 million Indians if those Indians refuse to cooperate.
The story of one man whose voice spoke out for millions.
To gain independence, we must prove worthy of it.
From his humble beginnings.
You're an ambitious man, Mr. Gandhi. I hope not.
To his ultimate triumph, he was the conscience of all mankind.
Where there's injustice, I've always believed in fighting.
I will fast as a penance for my part in arousing such emotions, and I will not stop until they stop.
His torment ended a nation's suffering.
I remember that all through history, the way of truth and love has always won.
His greatest weapon was peace.
In this cause, I too am prepared to die.
The houses are haunted by white nightgowns. None are green, or purple with green rings, or green with yellow rings, or yellow with blue rings. None of them are strange, with socks of lace and beaded ceintures. People are not going to dream of baboons and periwinkles. Only Here and there, an old sailor, drunk and asleep in his boots, catches tigers in red weather. One must have a mind of winter to regard the frost and the boughs of the pine trees crusted with snow, and have been cold a long time to behold the junipers shagged with ice, the spruces rough in the distant glitter of the January sun, and not to think of any misery in the sound of the wind, in the sound of a few leaves, which is the sound of the land full of the same wind that is blowing in the same bare place for the listener, who listens in the snow and nothing himself beholds, nothing that is not there, and the nothing that is.
Among 20 snowy mountains, the only moving thing was the eye of the blackbird. I was of three minds, like a tree in which there are three blackbirds. The blackbird whirled in the autumn winds. It was a small part of the pantomime. A man and a woman are one. A man, a woman, and a blackbird are one.
I extend the good wishes of every man, woman, and child of Fredonia.
Never mind that stuff. Take a card.
Card? What'll I do with the card?
You can keep it. I've got 51 left. Now, what were you saying?
As chairwoman of the reception committee, I welcome you with open arms.
Is that so? How late do you stay open?
I've sponsored your appointment because I feel you are the most able statesman of all Fredonia.
Well, that covers a lot of ground. Say, you cover a lot of ground yourself. You better beat it. I hear they're going to tear you down and put up an office building where you're standing. You can leave in a taxi. If you can't get a taxi, you can leave in a huff. If that's too soon, you can leave in a minute and a huff. You know you haven't stopped talking since I came here? You must have been vaccinated with a phonograph needle.
The future of Fredonia rests on you. Promise me you'll follow in the footsteps of my husband.
How do you like that? I haven't been on the job 5 minutes and already she's making advances to me. Not that I care, but where is your husband?
Why, he's dead.
I'll bet he's just using that as an excuse.
I was with him till the very end.
No wonder he passed away.
I held him in my arms and kissed him.
Oh, I see. Then it was murder. Will you marry me? Did he leave you any money? Answer the second question first.
Old man, you never should have gone to the police, you know. You ought to leave this thing alone.
Have you ever seen any of your victims?
You know, I never feel comfortable on these sort of things. Victims? Be melodramatic. Look down there. Would you really feel any pity if one of those dots stopped moving forever? If I offered you £20,000 for every dot that stopped, would you really, old man, tell me to keep my money? Or would you calculate how many dots you could afford to spend? Free of income tax, old man. Free of income tax? The only way you can save money nowadays.
A lot of good your money will do you in jail.
That jail's in another zone. There's no proof against me. Besides you.
Save your mind. dancing in the gym. You both kicked off your shoes. Man, I dig those rhythm and blues. I was a lonely teenage bronc and buck with a pink carnation and a pickup truck. But I knew I was out of luck the day the music died. I started singing bye bye, Miss American Pie. Drove my Chevy to the levee, but the levee was dry. Them good old boys were drinking whiskey and rye and singing, this'll be the day that I die. This'll be the day that I die.
And how did you get into the punk scene? How did all of that start for you?
Well, I wouldn't put that I got into the punk scene. I mean, punk was a word that was applied to what we were doing after we started it. But, you know, when we were starting out, just as kind of lonely, hungry kids from the sticks in New York, we thought that the whole world looked all, you know, pompous and sentimental and dishonest. And
started off wanting to do that with your writing and then went into music, is that right? Hoping to be able to do it through the band scene.
Yeah, I mean, I came to New York to be a writer, but that felt futile then because, you know, it didn't seem like my generation really read. Mm-hmm. And I could kind of, you know, I mean, I could respect that. I mean, even though it's kind of an acquired taste reading, you know, and,
it was easier to reach them through music.
Yeah, yeah.
I was saying let me out of here before I was even born. It's such a gamble when you get a face. It's fascinating to observe what the mirror does, but when I dine it for the wall and I've set a place, I belong to the blank generation and I can take it or leave it.
Yeah.